Good evening, everybody. Today, let me invite you again for the session of discrete time Fourier transform properties. Right? Discrete time Fourier transform properties. Right? Frequency shift property and scaling property we'll do today. We'll see these most beautiful properties. Where exactly it is applying, also we'll see. Right? Along with the proof. Now, this is coming under a topic, coming under VTU syllabus. For 4th semester student ECE, specifically, under module 4, right? This also can be studied by any other students also, signal processing, signal systems, or DSP, right? Or anybody, whoever, other than this engineering, whoever interested in signal processing, be M.Tech, or PhD, or even the software engineers who are interested in core processing, right? Signal processing areas, if you are looking, these are the basic properties, basic of signal systems, all these sessions, please use it, right. Now, this is my lecturing, five sessions, fifth lecturing sessions. In all my previous sessions, we discussed about DFT, impedance of Fourier transform, conversions of signals from time domain to frequency domain, and finding out DTFT for simple signals, so for simple signals of X of N analyzed. And then complex signals we seen, right, exponential, rectangular, right, all that we have seen. And we have drawn the spectrum for all that, right, spectrums we have studied, right, how to draw the spectrum. X of e power j omega versus omega we drawn. Magnitude spectrum, phase spectrum, we have seen all that. Then you can analyze signals beautifully in frequency domain compared to time domain x of n. Right, you will not get any information set to time domain. But you will get maximum information in frequency domain. That's how you can process now your signals better. Right? And you will understand this many channels we are all using today without overlapping because of, there are tools. This is thanks to Fourier. There are properties which helps now. Right? Today, and also last class, last sessions maybe, right? And we have seen linearity property and right, time shift property we have shown. Today we will see frequency shift property and scaling property, how exactly this influences in signal processing. We'll prove this first. Right. First, let me take frequency shift property. Name itself is telling. Frequency shift property in the frequency domain, frequency, signal frequencies, where shifting happens, that is beta. Let's see, what is this? Let me read first statement. If DTFT of X of N signal is X of DTFT of time domain signal X of N gives X of e power j omega in frequency domain. This frequency representations of this time domain. Then standard. Then find out DTFT of, prove that y of n. Right, y of n means this. Prove that x of n into multiplied by this your input sequence multiplied with exponential of j beta n. J beta n. Beta is a parameter. Right. Then if this is multiplied exponentially input signal here in the time domain, then after taking DT of T, discrete time Fourier transforms, in the frequency side, it is like this. It is equivalent to y of e power j omega, which is equal to x of e power plus j into alpha omega minus this beta. Whatever beta you are multiplying now, that is shifted, frequency shifted, frequency shift is nothing but that, right? E power j omega, omega is shifted to thus that you take this beta and write it here, right? That's the meaning of frequency shift property. In the frequency domain, you are using beta parameter and you are shifting that beta parameter to here, and your x of frequency is x of e power j into instead of omega, omega minus beta. This is the statement, right? What's the meaning? If you multiply any signals x of n in time domain with exponential signal such with exponential term such a way that e power j into beta n, then in the frequency domain, in the representations of what is the spectrum, it is equivalent to e power x of e power j into omega minus this shift, whatever shift is giving that. That's the statement. Proof is very, very easy. This is there in your signal processing applications today. Right. You will not get simple signals in multiprocessing today. Right. you will always get the signal multiplied with exponential only. Exponential, that too, e power j beta is nothing but e power, exponential is means what? E power j theta is nothing but cos theta minus j sin theta. Right? That means, is always having cos and sin terms. Right? Always. Complex processing is not mere just a simple signal. Always multiplied with cos and sin. Right? That way, signal processing takes place. Now, let me go for proof. That is significance. Now, proof is simple. Write the first line standard equation. We know that for this signal, input signal x of n, the frequency domain representation is x of e power j omega is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e power minus j omega n. This is standard way of representing signals from time domain to frequency domain. Right. Next. Similarly, write y of e power j omega, because y of n is asking. Y of n is this. Y of n is. Now, y of n is equal to, similarly, y of e power j omega is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. Similarly, y of n signal. Y of n e power minus j omega n. But what is y of n? He is asking, substitute that. Y of n is this, right? Y of n is this. X of n multiplied with exponential beta terms, right? Now, substitute that. Therefore, RHS is equal to y of e power j omega is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity into e power j beta n into x of n is what LHS. Is LHS you substitute there. Right? Now, into e power minus j omega n, which is a formula. Right? Now, summation, therefore right side is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity. X of n you take first outside. X of n into, write this e power j beta type. J beta n, this is what I am multiplying parameter this side, into e power minus j omega n, just maths, right? See this, I want somehow this term, that's why. What is the term I want in RHS? Always when you are proving LHS is equal to RHS, the other things are same, frequency shift is there in all time domain, LTA system, Z transform, everywhere. Thing is, you should know LHS, RHS, what is equivalent. Omega minus beta I want. In RHS. That is why I am doing this actually. Circus. E power j beta n into e power minus j omega n. Now combine this. You will get x of n this thing into e power minus j into omega. Now see. E power minus j omega n. You need no. Omega minus beta into n. That is e power minus j omega n. First term. Right. This first term you will get. E power minus j omega n. This. Minus beta. E power minus j, minus of minus is plus, minus e power j beta n, that is second term. That's what second term will get. This way I write. Why? Because I want this term only. Omega minus beta. Now this is a standard equation. Now we can write this right side as x of y of e power j omega is equal to x of e power j into omega minus beta. Now see, this is a standard equation. Summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n e power instead of minus j omega n omega instead I am having omega minus beta, that's all, right? Otherwise it is standard equation. Now see, we know this is standard equation. X of e power j omega for x of n is summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n e power minus j omega n, standard equation. Here in place of omega I am having omega minus beta. Therefore you write, since you are writing this as x of e power j omega, here you have to write a x of e power j of, what is omega? Omega in this case, omega minus beta. That is what your RHS. Now, this is what you mean. Omega minus beta, that's all. Other things are same, like your standard. Therefore, x of e power plus j omega minus beta, which is what RHS. That's what you want to prove. See this? That's what this property. You have to prove LHS this is equal to RHS is this frequency shift e power x of e power j omega minus beta. Hence the property is proved. What is that? Only two lines. First, write the statement. Frequency shift is nothing but frequency in frequency domain shift happens. That is omega minus beta. Whatever the term you are multiplying beta, no, that shift, that's all. Now that is the statement. To the proof, simple, right? First, x of e power j omega in frequency domain. For the x of input, then write the same for y of e power j omega. Then substitute what is y of n, that is LHS. Then take out x of n separate, e power j beta term this side. Then combine this, you will get omega minus beta, because that is what RHS. I want this, right? Then afterwards, what is that? That is the answer. That's all, because standard expression is that. That's all frequency shift property. Right. Next, scaling property. This is also very, very important. See this line only, the term only, that is the property. Scaling is the term actually. Earlier, like frequency shift in their frequency domain. Here, scaling in frequency. What is that? In frequency domain. Actually, it is also called as scaling frequency domain property. Right. What is that? Scaling term is 1 by p. The here, you have to multiply, right? You have to write x of e power j in the frequency domain, omega instead, 1 by p scaling factor you have to write. That's what I am writing, 1 by p. Right. What this property says? Scaling term comes in frequency domain. Now see. First, write the statement. DTFT of any signal x of n is x of e power j omega. That is frequency domain representation. Then, DTFT of the signal z of n is equal to signal multiplied by PL. P. For example, x of n is there. Multiply. In your signal processing, you will not have simple signals. You will always have 1000 times of n or 100 times of n, maybe in image or in a signal multiprocessing. X of PN. Now, DTFT of this X of PN is equivalent to in frequency domain, which is equal to Z of E power J omega, which is equal to X of E power J, instead of J omega, you are writing scaling factor 1 by P. This is scaling factor. P is there, no? 1 by P is the scaling factor. In frequency domain only. Scaling frequency, right, domain property. That's what actually. X of e power j omega by 1 by p. That you have to put. Are you understanding? So significance is, you will not get in a signal processing of today, you will not get simple signal. You will always have a signal along with multiplied with 1000 times, 100 times, 1 lakh times, like that. Then it is always in the frequency domain easy. What you have to do? In the spectrum, you have to analyze, you have to get for spectrum, it is equivalent to x of e power j omega by scaling factor is 1 by p. 1 by p is the scaling factor. This is the statement. Proof is very simple. Now as usual, go for x of e power j omega, write the standard equation. Frequency domain. Frequency domain representations of your time domain x of n is x of e power j omega is equal to n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e power minus j omega n. For standard equation. Similarly, write for z of, what is that he is giving? He is asking x, z of n is equal to x of pn. Now write that also frequency domain representation z of e power j omega is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity. Instead of x of n, it is z of n into e power minus j omega n. What is z there? Z of n? Z of n is x of p, x of pn. That is what this multiplier signal. X of pn inside a time. Right. Now write, substitute that x of pn into e power minus j omega n. Now split this. Now, whenever you are getting like this, right? Now what you should do? You have to substitute n as n. For example, summation n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity as summation n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. 100 times you have done. Simplification purpose. Now, what you should do? Substitute m as, one more parameter I want m, right? M as np. This np is there now. Substitute m is equal to pn or np, right? Then, your this summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity changes to summation m is equal to minus infinity plus infinity n to m. Then how this is? I have shown here like all others. That is, when n is equal to minus infinity, when n is equal to minus infinity, lower limit, then what happens to m? M is equal to pn, m is equal to p into minus infinity, that is minus infinity. Therefore, new limit is, see this, new limit is m is equal to minus infinity. Similarly, right side, upper limit. When n is equal to plus infinity, m also plus infinity will get. How? When n is equal to plus infinity, m is equal to pn, m is equal to p into what is n? Plus infinity, that is plus infinity. Therefore, summation change from minus infinity to plus infinity. See this? That's what this. Summation change, m is equal to minus infinity plus infinity, z of e power j omega is equal to x of, see this, x of, what is pn? Pn is m. Therefore, x of m. Now see, x of m into e power minus j omega. What is this? This n e power j minus j omega. What is n? N is nothing but m by p. M by p. Over now. That is the scaling factor. N is nothing but m by p. Now,
always see your RHS. See, 1 by 3 terms I have got now. 1 by 3 is the scaling factor I need in the right side. See that, what is the statement? 1 by 3 I want along with e power j omega. Now they are just to the mass multiple, what is it? Modifications now. 1 by 3 terms getting now, then write m is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of m, m x of m e power minus j omega by 3. I want this omega by p, just write this by this omega by p into m right side. Now this is standard equation, summation m is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of m e power minus j omega m. Instead of omega, I am having omega by p, right? This is equivalent to our scaling factor is 1 by p now. That is what extra. Earlier standard equation is summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n e power minus j omega n. Here instead of n, m I am having. Instead of n, m I am having because m I have changed. Then m is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of m e power minus j of something into m. Now scaling factor is 1 by n. Now this is equivalent to, see now, z of e power j omega is equal to answer. X of, this can be written as e power j into what is omega? Omega in place, omega by p is there. It is exactly like this. X of e power j omega is equal to standard equation. Summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity. X of n into e power j omega n is there. Omega plus omega by p is there. This can be written like, what is that? Written as, right, this can be written as, right, this can be written as omega x of e power j omega, no? Similarly, here x of e power j omega by p. That's why. That is equal to RHS. Now proved in the right side, in the frequency domain, I am having a scaling factor 1 by p. Right. Instead of j omega by p. Hence, the scaling property is proved. What's that? Let me repeat quickly. Scaling property says that this is the statement. X of n is x of e power j omega. If you multiply your input with 100 times p, then always equivalent is scaling. X of e power j omega into scaled by 1 by p, the frequency domain. This you have to prove. Now, write standard equations for x of n. Write standard equations for z of n. Then z of n in place, you substitute your LHS. This is what LHS. Write LHS here. Now see this, LHS. Right? Then substitute. Then do the math. Z of n, x of n. Then change this n to m. Then substitute m as pn. Then limit changes from here to m is equal to minus infinity plus infinity. That is shown here. Then z of e power j omega is equal to summation m is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of m into e power minus j omega m by p. Just I am having the omega is also, m is also same, j is also same, x of m is also same. Omega by p is there. Therefore, that is scaling factor. Therefore, this is equal to x of e power j omega by p. That's all the RHS. Hence, the scaling property is proved. I hope I am clear with both the properties. Scaling property and also the other property is, right, frequency shift property. Both are very, very important in today's signal processing. You will not get a simple signal processing of x of n signal always. No. You will always get a scaling of 1000 times, 100 times like this. And then the previous also like that only. Shift in frequency because it is time delay. Time delay is, right, frequency shift happens. Right. Next class maybe, let us see the some more properties. Right. Some more property like convolutions property and so many properties are there still. Right. That will all help in signal processing. Right. Till that, thank you. Thank you one and all for patience listening. Right. And before that, let me read this sentence. Right. Arise, awake, sleep not till you understand the concepts. You students. Students may be not only students. You may be students. You may be, teaching professions, or you may be a software engineer. You all have to study a concept fully, right? Then, this may not be for only one profession, studying profession as a student, right? We are all students, right? Involve in any of the other works, whoever is doing. Involve in any of the other work and just go on doing with great involvement. You will not get sleep at all first. Where is sleep not? You will not get sleep at all. That way you can enjoy the things. Thank you. Thank you.